How was that? Was that too loud? What's going on, guys? Welcome into the stream. Happy Monday. That was cool. I made it. I made it earlier. It's quite loud. Okay, I'll have to turn it down. But you know what? I've already turned it down because I thought it was loud. At least we all know when I transition. Hell yeah. Just like this. And then I can push this button here to fix it. To go to the small view if we're playing Kerbal or Cities. And then we're good to go after that. Alright, so let me look around through here. Let me click some of that. And we're good to go. Start game. Sounds like a soundbite you'd hear on like American Gladiator. So I downloaded some free sound effects. I downloaded a whoosh sound effect, which is the whoosh. And I downloaded a sword being drawn from a sheath, which is the same sound effect in the resub message with the Lord of the Rings stuff and Captain Ash Bacon. It's good to see you back in the armament. The sword's like, shing. It's the same sound effect. I thought it was pretty cool. I was like, hey, I used that one already. Okay, so let's go. Resume saved. We are kicking ass and taking names. Yeah, I downloaded the file and then realized I already had that file, but I used it anyways because it's nice. Okay. $7.5 million. Let's go check mission control. Plant a flag on the Mun. Will? No. No, I'm not gonna do it. You can't make me. Even though you're gonna pay me $150,000, I won't do it. Active. Gilly, 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 Moho. So we do have to send another ship out to Moho. I probably do want to send another transfer stage like we made yesterday and send one to Moho. We are going to be joining it around the orbit with the other one just to get credit for this. But then we have to return from orbit of the Mun. We could use that relay that exists as a relay for the lander. No, we can't do that because it has to have fuel. It has to have a ballistic landing, or it has to have an actual landing. Let's double check stuff over here. That sound effect. Striker, what's up, dude? Thank you for the 9 months. It's good to see you. And how are you? Xanath, no SSTOs. We're not going to do that. I'm not an SSTO person. You're not going to see those here, my friend. I apologize. Well, so Xanath, the base game actually has an SSTO that's less than 50 tons, I think. Let's go back to the main menu real quick. I'll double check. So if I go to start new and we go to sandbox and I hit start, let's go check real quick. Hi, Trigger Man. How are you, bud? We're going to go into the VAB. Actually, I guess I should go to the space plane hangar, right? And then go to load. They've got stock ships here. And they've got an SSTO, the Strato Launcher. Wait, that's not the right one. It's this one. This one here? Is that an SSTO? No, that's not an SSTO. That's like the Virgin Mobile plane. Gull Dove. Is this it right here? The Eris? Here you go. This is an SSTO and it weighs 19 tons. So yeah, I mean, we could make an SSTO. Thank you, Trigger Man. I appreciate that. But I don't want to. I don't care. That's not something I want to put a lot of time into. And in fact, Xanath, I'm going to be honest with you. A lot of people come over here to get away from that because they don't like that EJ's still on about it. So if I start getting into it, they're going to be like, oh God, now everybody's doing it. And I really don't want to jump on that train. Go watch EJ for that. I'm not going to step on his toes. All right, let's go back to the main menu. Nah, I'd rather just build rockets and go out. It says Monday. I just changed it. All right, let's go. But yeah, so we can make a 50-ton SSTO, but there's no reason to. We don't need it for any of our mission stuff. Because even if we did make it, we're not going to be able to get payload out very well. We're better off just using our smaller rockets. All right, Kerbin to Eves in 185 days. All right. So in my hard mode save, Xanath, I do have I do have SSTOs first stage. Let me Let me copy them over. I wonder how big that folder is. One second. I have Steam Apps Common Kerbal Saves Space. No, that wasn't it. It was Y. And that folder size is 1 gigabyte. Holy cow. I do have some chips, though. How big is the chips folder? Let's check this. 80 megabytes. All right. Space plane hangar. So yeah, I've got stuff here. Let me move them over and I'll show some of them to you. Those are a space plane hangar. Hold on. VAB. All of them should be. Those are the brains. Where are they at? Did I put ASA in front of them first? It's been so long since I've looked at this. Oh, here we go. Mace, Dirk, Axe. Yeah, let me transfer these over real quick. Let me grab my bot. Bot. We're gonna go Mace. And then Dirk. And then Axe. I named them after weapons in the armament. We got Sword. Oh, that was the wrong sword. I still only got Panthers, so my SSTOs are basic. Hi, Katsumi. How you doing? You can't get cargo into the bays before launch? Just put them in the bays in the VAB or the space plane hangar. You don't have to go all crazy like EJ does and like load everything with a crane and stuff. He's not playing Kerbal. He's playing Space Agency Simulator. He's on a whole different level. He's weird. He likes to just go hard, man. He's crazy. I can never do what he's doing. More power to him. All right. Let me pop over here real quick. It's gonna be loud. No, it's not. Okay. Let me grab these crafts off of here and then we'll load them up and take a look at them for sure. So if I go local disk program data, I just want you guys to see my DMs. Program files, Steam Common, where'd Common go? Steam Apps Common Kerbal, ships, wrong, saves, 50 ton challenge, ships, VAB. Okay, so there's that. We're gonna grab these and go 4K, 4K. 4K, 4K, and then 4K. We had 10, 20, 40, 80, and 160 ton capabilities, and they were SSTO. They were single stage to orbits. We're gonna go back and hit paste. We're gonna close that and then pop back over to here. How you doing, Rogue? Welcome in. Not lewd DMs, just DMs you guys shouldn't be looking at, and that's why they're called DMs. They have them in order in the last person you message, and you guys don't need to see that. So let me show you. ASA right here. So for instance, this is our, I guess this one isn't an SSTO. Hold on. That one's not an SSTO, but it is recoverable. The SRBs make it non-SSTO. So we're gonna need like the Dirk. This one here is an SSTO. It can hold 10 tons and put 10 tons into orbit and then come back and be recovered. This one here can put 20 tons into orbit and then come back down. So yeah, that's what we were, that this was our hard mode stages. And then here's the brain. This was the relay, the probe core. It had solar panels, that way it can stay out in a parking orbit and then return back if it needed to. This was the sword. This was 20 tons. And then after that was the axe, which you saw. The axe is 40 tons. Then the mace was 80 tons. And then, or I'm sorry, that was 40. The other one was 80. And then the maul was 160 tons into orbit. Do they propulsively land? I can get them to propulsively land. So, like, for instance, here, I'll do a smaller one. Let me do the sword. So if I did the sword and we threw 20 tons on it. Let me throw 20 tons on it real quick. Let me go. Wait, we're at 261 tons. This is not part of our 50-ton challenge, by the way. This is just me showing off something. So just bear with me 1 second. If I were to take, let's go wrong, 1.8 decoupler, and then it would be, I'm just going to pile some fuel on it. There should be, this is 10 tons, so that's 10. And then this is another 10, so that's 20-ish. It's a little more than 20, but we can still make this work. And they'll put a fairing around it for it to work correctly. So this would technically be like our stage. And we could launch this into space. Let me double check everything is in the right spot because the staging's all messed up. So there's the first stage. It's literally all it is this first stage. And then we can hit save and launch. I'll show it to you real quick. Well, no, it has chutes, but we can ballistically, we can propulsively land them, Hip Hop. I'll show you, watch. I'll show you. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Check it out, man. Watch our big rocket at work. So these have 4,000 delta V at them and still push a payload into space. Nice rocket. Thanks, Speedworks. This is from our old hard mode save. I just wanted to fly one real quick. It's been a while since I've done it. I guess it depends on how much fuel is left. No, because we're usually around 250-ish meters a second coming down. And all you need is about 300 or 400 delta V, which is really easy to get if you try hard enough. I'm pretty good at this game. I've played a lot of hours. A lot of my hours go into designing things that are quick and efficient. I don't care about how things look. I'm a big fan of function over form. If you see video games I play in the past, I don't care how something looks as long as it works. That's my selling point when I'm dating, by the way, ladies. You shouldn't care about how I look. Just know that I put the work in for it. And then we go from there, obviously. So we're going to go up. We keep ourselves under 2.0 TWR. We kind of went up a little too quick on this ascension stage. Rogue, go for it, buddy. Hip Hop, it's good to see you, my friend. I hope you're having a good day. We were talking about you yesterday. I think it was yesterday, the day before, some talk about Big Daddy came up and someone referenced the line. And I was like, funny that you say that. We have somebody in the community who's named that. An excellent Monday? That's good to hear. If I offset things with the offset tool, I go to the length of adding struts or something to make it look good. I'm bad for that. I mean, that's fine. Depending on what kind of machine you have, you got to worry about part count when it comes to things like that. Because the more parts you have on your vessel, the more shit your computer's going to run. So you got to keep that in mind. And if you add a bunch of struts and panels and things just to clean something up, your computer's going to run like crap for no reason. So we're going to work on getting this thing up and around. I usually stop right here around 80, and then I wait till we get ourselves up and through. We usually pop this off right around 60 or so. This is our payload. We usually pop this off. This is our ship here. And then we extend the solar panels. This is our stage to bring it back if we needed to use the chutes and stuff. I use the chutes. Because I was lazy and didn't feel like trying to propulse return it. But we can definitely do it. It's been a while since I've flown these. So 69, 70. All right, let's lock us in prograde. Are the fins even necessary for this lifter? Do they actually stabilize? I don't know. We did it just for funsies. I couldn't tell you if they do or not. I was just trying to make all the stages look the same at the end of the day. And that was our compromise. Okay, so we are burning faster than we need to. Let me go a little closer to zero. So we're trying to get ourselves to an 80 by 80. Usually I go for 100, which we probably have enough delta D to V to do both. But just getting it into orbit is enough to show proof of concept. I'm not going to sit here and try to zero out all of our orbits. So there's 83 by 80. We have 800 delta V left. So what I normally would do here is I would, take this stage off right here and decouple it. It would take off on its own. Then we end up gaining a lot of delta V from it. So then we want to go ahead and make our move. We turn on our RCS. The RCS is top heavy. It helps us turn the ship around when it comes time. So I usually pick a point right about here and add a maneuver and get a burn started. 500-ish delta V leaves us with 700. I'll probably move it to about here. I'll speed the game up. It's going to move us around. What's up, Mo Bogsley? How are you, my friend? It's good to see you. Happy Monday. How was your weekend besides your little, what is that game called? Flesh and Blood? You nerd, by the way. Okay, we're going to aim for our maneuver. This is where the RCS comes into play on this. It's the only reason why I use it is for this kind of adjustment. And then I've been working on trying to get myself close with this. I still sometimes screw up, but we can try. I try to get as close to KSC as possible because we needed to recover for maximum funds because it's hard mode. In hard mode, every little bit counts. Or someone else did theirs recently, or may you have bad lag. It came through. Did anyone else not hear it? I heard it. I don't know what to tell you, buddy. You got an ad, you'll reply in a second. How dare you? You didn't hear it? Oh, it came through. I heard it. Oh, well, Mew, you gotta try it again in 10 minutes, my friend. Or an hour or something. Haven't heard any of the personal commands. That was the only one. Unless there was another one. But I think that was the only one. There, you hear it now? You did speed 2 earlier? Okay. Here. I heard them. Look, I can hear him again. All right, so we're going to go ahead and burn this in. 8 seconds. 2, 1. That might be too close. Either way, we can work on it. We got 700 delta V. Why isn't the RCS working? Are we out? No, we have plenty of monoprop. What's going on? Hello? What's going on here? I don't know. You're hearing voices more than normal? It's okay. Just another day in my stream. Hi, Supercat. How are you? Welcome in. It's good to see you today. Hope you're well. Striker, thanks for being here. If I didn't say hi. We're just currently flying. This is our old hard mode rockets for those of you who remember the hard mode run that we did. So right as we come over this mountain, we usually bring in the solar panels because we don't need them anymore. And then yeah, we can try and propulsively bring this in. Good luck to us. Like always, noise. All right, so we're coming in. We might actually land in the mountains or something. I'm never good with this. Sometimes I'm either right on, sometimes I'm way short, sometimes I'm way over, and I come in almost the same way every time. I guess it's whatever the game wants to do for me during this time period. I think this time we're going to be way short. Switch over to surface. Probably turn the RCS off. The only bad thing about trying to propulsively land these hip-hop is that they're very, very top-heavy. And even if we did touch down, if we're on any uneven surface, it flips over and blows up because my RCS isn't powerful enough. So I'm going to have them on standby in case it doesn't work out. Well, Xanath, I mean, that's the plan. See, I would use shoots here, but we're gonna try and sit it down like normal people. It's really close to the pad. It's like one of our closest landings. The closest I ever got was 1.2 kilometers from the clamps. Venser? What are you talking about? You mean Verners? No, I don't have Verners. See, it doesn't really come down very softly. That's why we use parachutes. Either way, we could have done it if I was better rocket flyer, but that's not what they're made for, hip hop. But yeah, I can do it if I really wanted to, but I really don't care. All right, so that's how that works. I would usually use the chutes, but there you go. There's your tech demo. Anywho, that was my hard mode save. Unfortunately, it's not on YouTube. Because we started putting videos up after that. So all that's been lost to the archives of the internet. Now, what were we working on? Oh, I want to load up this craft and see if it's good. Yeah, we did hip-hop. We did and we succeeded a few times. Because there's no saving, no reverting in hard mode. So I didn't really want to risk it all the time. But if we were like really accessing money, I gave it a shot. And sometimes we did, sometimes we didn't. Because sometimes the contract paid so much that recovering $30,000 worth of rocket wasn't really worth it. You know, it kind of overwrote that, so it was worth it to try to ballistically land it or propulsively land it. And we did it a few times. But we didn't do it enough to where I was good at it. Okay, so C is the rover. A was the whole kit and caboodle, right? Yes, okay. So this is our transfer stage that we're sending to all of the various atmospheric bodies in order to enter the rover into the atmosphere. But I want to see how much this has on, like, MOHO. 0.37. Okay, so it's not enough. I was seeing if it was possible for us to use this in some kind of application. But it is not. So we would have to use the other one. Few works, my Monday's going pretty well, man. It's good to see you. Thanks for coming by and hanging out. All right, so that's not enough to do MOHO. God, MOHO is such a pain in the ass, guys. I'm so annoyed by it. So we'll have to do a special one for MOHO. We currently have ELU coming up in 324 days, but this EVE one's the most important one that we're trying to hit now. So let's not worry about this. what is this around Gilly? 20 TWR around Gilly? Okay. Yeah, we got our vessel in orbit, but I ran out of Delta V. It was a lot more Delta V to get around it than what I expected. Can you launch in the plane of MOHO on launch? What? You mean like to hit it when the plane hits? Sure, but I don't know when that is. I'm not going to sit here and try to triangulate that kind of stuff. None of the resources that exist online get that right. But yeah, of course we can do that. It's just never accurate anymore. The game doesn't do a good job with that kind of stuff anymore. Mo Bogsley, did you have a 10-minute ad? My weekend was pretty good, buddy. It's good to see you. Congrats on your flesh and blood. You're at work. Are you still working the same job or are you somewhere else? All right, let me think here for a second. So we don't need this. We only need to have this for Gilly. We could send that just straight to Gilly. Same job, just applying for others right now. Flesh and blood is great. I'm glad you're enjoying it, man. I can't afford to get into it. The barrier of entry is way too high. I've already got my money tied into Magic. Alright. You kinda left Magic. You don't ever leave Magic. You'll be back. How much Delta V is it for one way to Eve? We can show you real quick. Let's see. Let me copy this and paste it, and we'll look at it together. Boom. One way to Eve, if you're getting into orbit, is 34, 43, 50, 44, 48, 49, 5,000, about 6,300 for one way orbit. If you wanted to land, it's probably about 6,500, but you need really good heat dissipation. Trying to take off from Eve is a bitch. But your last stage only needs about 2,500 Delta V to get there. Then come back, it takes a little more, obviously. But we're going to Gilly. We have a couple ships going to Gilly, which is different. Mew, it's why it's called a collectible card game. It's called a CCG, not a TCG. It brands itself that way on purpose.